हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज़ हरलीन कौर। टुडे वी विल बी टेकिंग स्पेशलाइजेशन ह्यूमन रिसोर्स प्लानिंग एंड डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एचआर यूनिट 1। द फर्स्ट टॉपिक इंक्लूड्स मैक्रो लेवल मैन पावर प्लानिंग। मैक्रो लेवल मैन पावर प्लानिंग इज लार्जली कंसर्न्ड विद लेबर सप्लाई। द सप्लाई ऑफ लेबर, द काइंड ऑफ लेबर वी गेट फ्रॉम द लेबर मार्केट इज द मैक्रो लेवल मैन पावर प्लानिंग। As we all know, human resource planning can be done both at macro as well as micro level. Macro level includes when the HRP planning is done globally, whereas micro level manpower planning includes when the human resource planning is done at the organization level. Macro level planning is influenced by environmental factors like employment and unemployment situations, demographic changes, legal control, and organization policies. Macro level manpower planning is controllable, uncontrollable, while micro level manpower planning is controllable. As micro level is done at organization level, so micro level human resource planning is controllable. It can be controlled. Now let's see need of human resource planning at macro level. Why we require a macro level manpower planning? First point includes employment and unemployment situation. Employment and employment situation means the type of workforce that we are labor market is having a skill shortage. They do not have a skill that is required by the organization. So we can say that the educated unemployment is on rise. We have educated people with us, but they are not quite skilled. This emphasizes the need for more efficient recruitment as well as retaining people. Now comes the technological change. Technology is again influencing the human resource planning. The change in the system, change in the pattern of taking the people in the organization, then the influence of technology in the work culture is making problem for human resource planning too. So retaining and redeployment of people is again a problem for the human resource planning system. All these contribute to need to plan human resource need intensively and systematically. So all the things should be in systematic manner. Demographic changes. As in organization, a diversified workforce is working, so human resource planning is influenced by the demography, our demography system. Age, sex, literacy, technical inputs, all these influence the has an implications on our human resource planning. Skill shortages. Unemployment does not mean that labor market is a buyer market. Organizations have generally become more complex and require wide range of specialized skills. So the labor market that is given people who are less skilled. So problem arises when such employee leaves, and if the skillful people leave, it's again a very big problem for the HR to recruit a person who is having a similar skill. Government legislations. Government legislation is again a disadvantage of human resource planning, as the government rules, regulation, their laws, their system influence our human resource planning. If we take an example, the weightage is given to the categories disabled, so the people who is having certain skill cannot be taken because of this particular reason. Now comes lead time. The long lead time is necessary in selection process, because selection process should be taken seriously so that a right candidate can be chosen for the particular position. Now let's see what are the government initiatives taken towards the development of manpower planning. First one includes population planning and control. There should be a proper management. There should be proper planning and control for the population, as our natural resources or the resources given by the organization is limited. So it should be given to the best people and pool of people who are need for that. If the population will increase day by day, then the majority of people will not get those facilities. Literacy and education. The national policy on education in 1986 provides a broad framework for complete eradication of illiteracy in the country by declaring basic preliminary level education free and compulsory. So, an institutional national policy education has introduced that the preliminary education should be given to the all the people who are in the country. So, the policy emphasizes on increased government and non-government expenditures. Healthcare and medical care. Health and nutrition constitutes one of the most important indicators of quality of human resource, as they contribute significantly to building and maintaining productive human resource, as well as improving average expectation of life and quality of life. So if the better health and medical facilities are given to the people, then they will be a better human resource for the organization, and their expectancy rate will increase, as well as their quality standard will increase, and they will contribute more to in the organization. Then comes housing. Housing sector is, according to the National Housing Policy in 1998, states that there should be a sustainable development of housing infrastructure for all the people in the country, in the partner with the public and private partnership, so that the person who is if he will have place to live, then only he will contribute in a proper manner in the organization. Now let's see the approaches to the macro level manpower planning. Macro level manpower planning includes the manpower requirement approach. This approach is used to recognize the area of shortage of manpower in economy and plan to train and provide the required skill manpower. Means we look for the area where the manpower in the economy is less, and we give the skill to improve the state of that particular area. It believes that if we require more production, then more skilled people are required. Rate of return approach or cost and benefit analysis includes the investment an organization done on the individual in their trainings, in their learning part, and how much an employee contribute for their contribute in the organization. This is the rate of return approach or the cost or benefit analysis. Social demand approach. Social demand approach includes the population who is in the country should be has an all the different education levels in includes. It should include all the education levels in the particular area, like revealing the enrollments of different education. Social demand approach is capable of revealing that the number of students with different types of professional preparation that is expected with great target data based on the past experience. Means we need to look upon the particular state, particular area, the according to the past data, the particular area is where they are lacking behind the education professionals in different areas, and then we need to add on those professional areas, those professional education people, so that the area is not has a lacuna in that particular sector. Now comes the another topic in this unit, that includes labor market analysis. Likewise, a market is a place where we buy or sell the products. Customer who buys the product and the seller who is the shopkeeper who sells the product. A labor market is also a place where we get the human resource as we demand for the human resource and then we get a supply of the human resource. So labor market is a place where the supply and demand of for the job meets with the worker or labor providing their service that employees demand. Labor market is process of balancing the demand for particular type of candidate with the supply of the same. So we balance the how much the demand is done and how much the supply is done. A labor market we balances it. It also ensures that it provides a competitive compensation packages to the workers. In labor market, it is particular that the person should get a proper compensation. Now comes the silent features of labor market. First is relationship. It is assumed that in labor market, the relationship between the employer and employees is very good. And the employee who is working in the organization retires from the same organization. Then comes terms and condition. It is included that the wages, the conditions, industrial relations is properly managed in labor market. Local character. Mostly Indian labor market is local in character. Sons of soil. What the father is doing, that the son will be doing. Low rate of mobility. Labor avoid its mobility from one place to another because of their homesickness, their closeness towards their family members. Because of this, the Indian labor market is less mobile. They don't like to move from their native place. Imperfect market. Workers do not get normal wage rate to which market rate normally trends. Wage differentials. In Indian labor market, wage inequalities suffers. Employers are more strengthened. They have more power in comparative to the employees. Unemployment. Most common in agriculture as well as small scale industry. Cottage industry, small scale industry, agriculture industry is having unemployment rate is more. Outsourcing. Indian labor market is dependent upon outsourcing. Shortage of skilled labor. Indian labor market is again suffering from the skilled labor. Then comes the second part of labor market in India, that is organized and unorganized labor market. Organized sector is one that is incorporated with the appropriate authority or government and follows its rules and regulations. Means that is influenced by the government, laws, rules, regulations, that is organized labor market. In India, employee of central, state government, banks, railways, insurance, industries are the organized sectors. Markets are standardized in this sector. Demand and supply of labor is balanced through the efforts of employment exchanges. Then people get trainings as well as development in this sector. Then comes the unorganized sector. Unorganized sector in economy consists of the household manufacturing activities or the small scale industry that do not linked with the government. They run their business in a short area, short term industry. So jobs here are low paid as well as often irregular payments are made. Mostly they do not have paid leaves, holidays, leave due to sickness, etc. Employment is also not sure. Demand and supply of labor is balanced through casual labor and contract labors. So these is the unorganized labor market. Then comes the bounded labor in labor market. Bounded labor is known as the boundage or the poonage happens when people give themselves in slavery as a security against loan or when they inherit a debt from a relative. Means if you have taken a kind of a loan from your relative and you are not able to pay that loan, then you became a slave or that particular relative, that is the bounded labor. But government of India has abolished this bounded labor. Now let's see what now the another topic, that is stock taking. Stock taking identifies how many people are needed at every level of organization to achieve organization objective. Stock means the people who are in the organization, who left the organization, who are in a process to join the organization is a stock. Maintaining of the record, maintaining of the stock of human resource. It tells organization what is exit in the stock and what is needed. So manpower stock should be updated every 2 years and include changes in such new skills added to employee as well as their knowledge. So employer manpower stock should be updated timely so that the record is maintained in the organization in a proper manner. Okay, thank you students for today.